Yeah. No. He's girl. He lives here.
So I played him in the game.
In the airline, it does because they can make it to the left.
It's like selling dirt twice. Like, I'm going to charge you.
Well, they did.
I'm going to charge you.
They did. Day. They sold the seat twice, basically.
Yeah. So, when I fly, we do. I've got the Delta after my fly. Yeah. And I'm a frequent flyer. And I fly two or three times a year. I use Delta almost exclusively as a fan. And I use it for personal trips. I can't use it.
Yeah, that's for sure. There's not a lot of choice.
But, yeah. So, I mean, right here, it's a good place to use the app. So, you go on the Delta app once you pay for your flight. Every time I've been on a plane in the last 2 years, I go in there and I take a fucking emergency on my so I have more legroom. Never crossed before. You know, which seat do you want? Well, here we go. There's your emergency. I take one of those, and I bring my bags in there, and if I get up for work, if I jump in, it costs me anything anyway, so I don't give a fuck. So, but if I do a personal stuff, I literally all stuff everything in my bag.
These days companies, well, they care almost as much about loyalty as they see the team. They like having a loyal customer is an easy customer.
No, the other thing I noticed is four of those 5 times I flew, I jumped up. One thing I noticed, I've been flying a lot. I've been flying since I was 7, but I saw my parents sitting down the ground. When I was a kid, I had a plane. Fucking camp, that's some interesting. Fucking
That's good.
Oh, no, that's your money. Yeah. So, you're going to get into this one. This paper that guy ends up being the captain. This guy is literally twice the size of Texas. Fucking real place. And you have to get in with weight. He just takes his hand up the thing, he's up in here, grabs a pan, and I'm looking at him, I'm like, he's not flying the plane, but he's literally, I mean, he's got something with his feet, but he's not doing anything with this, and we're not on autopilot stuff. He's just playing,
got a sandwich in his hand.
This plane looks like something that Amelia Earhart might have pulled, right? The jazz is over, Russell Brogan. It literally has sun visors. So we're flying up, anyway. We finally level on it.
Yep.
And this fucking place. Shit, we're not really all the time. This plane is going straight from the plane's like. It's like this. Weird, right? Not like in this plane, the like, there's no fucking way I'm going to do this.
Right? I'm taking a boat back.
I'm taking a boat back with this fucking shit. I'm just choosing the key to the state. And I'm looking around for like an airplane. And I don't see. We come land and I'm like, I bust up my phone. I hit record and I'm like, this is my last video effort. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna die. And I'm recording the landing. We're coming down what looks like a cartel drug plane.
It probably was.
The cartel.
We're coming to the Bahamas, man.
They're not shooting at you on your way in. We know they'll be shooting your way out.
We make sure your seatbelts are fastened.
Oh, God.
The artillery were flying in.
The craziest thing of all of it was we landed. Literally, it was the smoothest landing I've ever had. It was unbelievable. And I was like, pull up, and their airport is like a building. And I want to say it was maybe 800 square feet. We get out and walk over there, and then this lady pulls up and she was like our host, my wife. But I'm serious, I thought I was going to die. I was fairly positive, like 80-90% that I was going to die. But the funny part was, I was like, fuck, this is awesome. I'm serious, that thing landed and it was like funny. I couldn't believe it. But I posted it on Facebook, I was like, I'm going to die, this is it.
The best part of my flight was that if everybody who's scheduled to be on the plane on that flight is there, regardless of what time, if they're in there an hour early, they'll wait. They're ready to go. They'll wait. So, scheduled 8 o'clock, I shit everybody's here.
They have as much money as we can up.
Well, no, so it's just, they're not subject to that schedule like the other airlines, right? Coming back, they would come back, we were song for the day, we would come back to the there was four of us on the plane. And we were all there, we were supposed to leave at 8. Everybody was there like 20 after. 20
when I built it. This plane we pulled is called Flamingo Air. They have.